Hi all, welcome to the channel Cloud Knowledge. Today in this video, we'll demonstrate control flow activity in ADF that is called as get metadata activity. This will be a short demo. So let's go to the get metadata activity documentation from Microsoft. So here, if we go to the data factory documentation under the concepts of the data factory, under the control flow, we have get metadata activity. So what is it? How it is used in ADF? We'll demonstrate. We can use this activity to retrieve the metadata of any data in ADF or Synapse pipeline. You can use the output from the get metadata activity in conditional expressions to perform validation or consume the metadata in subsequent activities. Okay, and later in this documentation they have given how we have to use it. Okay, so let's go to the data factory and see how we can use the get metadata activity. So let's go to the auto tab in the ADF and create a new pipeline, and we'll name the pipeline as get metadata. Okay, now I'll show you from where we'll get the metadata. So if we go here to the container, cloud knowledge into container, and inside the test input folder, we'll traverse here and we'll try to connect to this storage gen 2 account to this container test input, and we'll try to view the contents which are present here. Okay, so inside the folder first we will see, and then we'll try to select one file and see the contents of it through the get metadata activity. So let's go back here in the ADF, and under the general tab we have the get metadata activity. So we'll take the get metadata activity in the canvas here, and once we take it, it shows three different sections. The first section is the general tab where we can name the get metadata activity. So get metadata, we'll leave it as is. So when we are constructing projects, we need to give proper names and descriptions, so that we will add. Rest of the settings we'll leave it as is, and we'll go to the main settings tab. Okay, so here we have to connect to the data set. The data set I've shown you is the storage account, folder, location, test input. Okay, so we'll try to click on plus new and connect to the gen 2 storage account, continue. So the files which are placed at this location are of different type, right? Some are zip, some are CSV, some are excels. Okay, so we'll select the CSV, that is the delimited text for now. We'll name the data set as get metadata input, and the link service we already have for the storage account, so we'll select that and browse to the file path. Okay, so it's inside the test input folder, and we have to select up to this level from the root folder just to the test input folder. Okay, so it has all the files as well as folders, right? CSVs, Excel, zip, JSON, Parquet, etc. So we'll click OK. We need not select any file here, so we have just selected up to the folder level. Okay, let's click on first row as header, import schema none, and then click OK. So this is done. So once we select the data set, next settings appear here. That is the field list. Okay, this is important. This is marked as mandatory field. So we'll click on plus new. And once we click on plus new, it will show you the different arguments which we can select, okay, from the field list. So since we have selected the folder, the arguments in the drop-down will be different. So the arguments, since we have selected the folder, right, test input folder, which has different types of files, it is showing us the different arguments list. That is child items, exists, item name, item type, last modified. Okay. So the child items, if we click on child items, okay, and then if we go to the standard documentation and search for child items, it says list of subfolders and files given in the folder. Okay, so it will give you the list of the files which are present at this location. Okay, so if we have the argument enabled child items, it will give you the list of the files which are present at this location, the storage location, folder location. So at this folder location inside the storage account, whatever files will be present will be shown to us when we have the argument child items. Okay, so next is, so let's now click on plus new and we want to add other field list arguments. Okay, so child items we have added. So next is item name. We'll leave exists. We'll cover this in a different video. We'll take item name. Then comes item type. And the last one is last modified. If we go back to the documentation and see one by one, item name is the name of the file or the folder. Item type is the type of the file or folder. So it will return whether the selected data set is file or folder. Okay. And rest of the metadata type, you can see we're not appearing here, right? Right. So if you click on the drop down, child item, item name, item type, and last modified. And here you can see that in the standard documentation, we have the size, we have other fields like content, MD, five, structure, etc., which are not showing here because we have selected the data set. If we open the data set up to the folder level, right? In the file path, we have up to the folder level. We have not selected any file. Okay, that's what I was trying to say, that we'll demonstrate for the file also the get metadata activity later. So for the folder level, we have given the arguments in the field list. And now we'll try to validate our get metadata activity. Click close and then try to debug. So the debug run is in progress and we'll wait for the get metadata activity to complete. So the get metadata succeeded. If we go and click over the input button, it will show us the data set. Okay, the input field list which we have given. Okay, that is, we have selected child items, item name, item type, last modified, and the settings, right? This we have given, and now we'll click on the output and we'll try to maximize the output so that we can properly view it. So it has given us item name. So in the data set, the selected item was a folder. So it is giving us the item name, that is the folder name, test input, right? We have selected up to the folder level. Then comes the item type, which we have given in the argument. So it is a folder. Tested input was a folder in the storage account. Last modified, when it was last modified, it has given us the date. Then comes the child items, which we have selected. The child items means whatever was the content inside that folder it has given us. So it has few files, right? Different CSVs were there, Excels were there, and there were these zip files, PaRKy files, JSON files, etc. Okay, as well as the folder, right? So we had two folders, input files and the JSON input. That is also shown here, and the type is also shown. That is, it is a folder type and the others are file type, right? Right? And the other folder is here. So as per the official documentation, in the child items, it will give you the list of the subfolders and the files in the given folder. So we have got the metadata of that folder location after selecting the field list which we want here. So once we get the output from the get metadata activity of a folder location, let's say we have this folder location, test input folder, and we want to perform some task with these files. Okay, suppose we want to check the contents of these files, the size of the these files, and then want to further process it to the downstream. Then we can use get metadata activity to work on the child items. So when we get the details of the folder and the files which are present there, we can further process down these files in the downstream and work in the pipeline to apply different conditions, right? So this is the first step where we get the contents of the files which are present at the folder location. Okay, so this is how we use get metadata activity over the folder location. Now let's take another get metadata activity in the canvas and then we'll connect this get metadata activity in the settings to a file location. Okay, so we'll go to the storage gen 2 account, delimited text, we'll name it as get metadata file input, and the link service we already know is there for the storage account, and the file path will go to the test input folder, and this time we'll select, let's say, any file from here. So let's select students.csv, click OK. First row has header, import schema none, and click OK. So this time we have selected the data set up to the file level. So if you open the data set, it shows file path, folder name, then comes the file name, that is students.csv. Okay, now we'll go back here and we have to select the field list, that is the arguments here. If we go here and see the drop down, since we have selected the file, it will show us the different options, that is the column count inside that file, content MD5 for that file, exists is already there, then item name, item type, last modified. Let's select all these. First we'll select the column count, next we'll select the content MD5, it will give you a hash function generated value, then comes item name, next one is item type, next we'll take last modified, let's take size, and the last one is the structure. Okay, so if you go back to the standard documentation to see what all these arguments mean, is that item name, item type is the same, it will give us the name of the file and the type of the file, right? Then comes the size. Size of the file, it will give in bytes. Okay, it is only applicable to the files, that's why it is written, it was not present for the folder. Size of the folder, it won't give. Then comes MD5. MD5 of the file, applicable only to files. MD5 is the hash generated value, hash function generated value. Then a structure, data structure of the file or relational database table. Return value is a list of column names on column types. Okay, so this we'll see once we execute the get metadata activity of the file. These all options we'll see once we execute the get metadata activity selected for the file. Column count, the number of columns in the file or relational table. Exists we'll see later. So the arguments we have selected for this get metadata one. So let's go back to the general tab and we'll write it is for the file. And this was for the folder, the name, right? So that once it is executed, we'll see which one to refer. So let's click on validate and click on debug. So the debug run is in progress for both the get metadata activities. Let's wait for its completion. In the meantime, let's go to the test input folder, and since we have selected students.csv file, we'll open this file here as well and click on edit to see the contents of this file. So it has two columns and has about 9 rows. Okay, so this is the content, and we can see the last modified date here. Okay, date and time, the size, right? All these will come to us in the pipeline through the get metadata activity. So let's go back here, and we could see that both the activities have successfully completed, and this time we'll focus on the get metadata file, right? So the input we have given is coming up here, and now we are going to see the output. Let's maximize the output, and it has shown us the first element as content MD5. The content MD5 has given us this random value generated with the hash function. Then comes item name. The item name selected was the file name students.csv. Item type is a file, right? This time we have selected the file, so it has given us the item type as file. Last modified date was 8/11/22, and if we go here and see here, it is 8/11/22, right? Then the size. Size, it was mentioned that it will be given in bytes. So 96 is mentioned here, and if we go here in the storage account, it shows 96 bytes. Okay, then comes the structure, And we know structure will be the data structure of the file. It will return a list of the column names and the column types. So the column names and the column types were, column name was student ID, total marks, and the type of the column, right? So if you open here, we have already seen that it had two columns, right? And both were of type string. So it has shown us the value as a string type for both the columns because it is a CSV, so the type is string. Next is the column count. The column count is 2. There were 2 columns, right? So 2 column count is given and the rest of the details, okay, related to the pipeline execution. So this is how we got the details through the get metadata activity of the folder level as well as of the file level. So at the folder level, what we have got is that we have got the details, the item name, item type, last modified, and the child items. That is inside that folder what all files are present. And then we can further process these files later in the pipeline. And at the file level, we got the details like the content MD5, item name, item type, last modified, size of the file, structure of the file, as well as the column count. So that we can further work down on this file and apply the logics required. So this was a small demo on the get metadata activity. We'll now proceed to the other activities and we'll use this get metadata activity as an existing activity and perform further operations down on these files and folders in the coming videos. Okay, so I hope you have understood the get metadata activity in the ADF. So if you have any questions or queries, do let me know in comments. Thank you for watching the video. Happy learning. Bye.